Triple H explains why NXT was not at Survivor Series. Referee Mike Chioda questions Vince McMahon's loyalty after being released by WWE. And Vince McMahon's role behind Drew McIntyre's new entrance is revealed. Hello everyone, Jose G here bringing you today's top stories in today's SK Wrestling News Roundup. Triple H on why WWE NXT was not at Survivor Series 2020. Survivor Series is the penultimate WWE pay-per-view of 2020, took place at the Thunderdome on November 22, 2020. WWE Raw and SmackDown went head-to-head in the Battle of Brand Supremacy, and the Red Brand came out on top with 4 wins from 7 matches. But this year, Survivor Series did not have NXT, which had won the brand wars last year, the very first time the black and gold brand took part in Survivor Series. The WWE Universe was surprised by the exclusion of NXT, who had dominated the pay-per-view last year, while also added a freshness to the brand wars. NXT Supremo Triple H opened up about NXT not being at Survivor Series and explained the reason for their absence. Triple H explained why NXT was not at Survivor Series. In his media call ahead of NXT TakeOver War Games, Triple H revealed that COVID-19 was the main reason that WWE NXT wasn't included to this year's Survivor Series lineup, saying, quote, "To be honest, I'm not in every aspect of creative decisions, but I also believe from the creative teams, as they are trying to build individual talents. They're not combining things too much. I also believe that COVID and the pandemic situation took a role in that. We tried to keep things somewhat separated between brands, between performance center, between things just to limit that exposure," end quote. He emphasized on how the pandemic is still going on and that they needed to keep the brands separately to ensure that there wasn't any exposure. He also said that the battle between the brands had to be built and that they had to have promotional time together, saying, quote, "You don't want to just do it out of the blue. You need to build to it. You need to have a lot of crisscrossing and promotional time together, and it just didn't seem like the right thing to do in a lot of ways," end quote. Dana Brooke posts picture of her black eye. Dana Brooke has taken to Twitter to show off the black eye that she received against Retribution's Reckoning on this week's WWE Raw. The Retribution member's WWE in-ring debut caused a lot of discussion online, especially after she lost her mask. Dana Brooke picked up the victory with a roll-up, prompting Retribution leader Mustafa Ali to make it clear that Reckoning is letting the faction down. The November 30th episode of WWE Raw saw Dana Brooke make an appearance during the match between Slapjack and Ricochet. Although Retribution Slapjack earned the win, the former Titus Worldwide member still made her presence felt by slapping Mustafa Ali at ringside. Later that night, Ali attempted to distract Dana Brooke by standing on the ring apron during her match against Reckoning. The plan backfired though, as she avoided a kick from Reckoning and quickly pinned her to win the match. The unmasked Reckoning, who performed as Mia Yim in NXT, felt that the wrath of Ali after the match. Retribution's leader repeatedly shouted, "There is no failure in Retribution," while she sat in the middle of the ring. Meanwhile, Dana Brooke made a done motion as she watched the faction's dissension from the stage area. Triple H confirms that WWE is open to working with other promotions. Triple H was back for another media call to promote the upcoming WWE NXT TakeOver War Games 2020 show, and the NXT boss was asked a plethora of questions about the product and its future. One of the most interesting questions from the call was regarding WWE's stance on working with other promotions. The recent revelation of AEW and Impact Wrestling working together has brought the attention back to WWE's dealings with other promotions. While Triple H didn't specifically name AEW or Impact Wrestling, Triple H noted that the WWE is open to working with other companies if the business opportunities seem right on paper. Triple H highlighted that WWE has already been making progress in the recent past with working with promotions such as Evolve, Progress, and ICW. Triple H felt that people often misinterpret WWE's business model. The game said that the company would be open to anything at any given time. It would all depend on the nature of the opportunity. Triple H explained that the long-term benefits needed to be considered when talking about a crossover plan. If it's meaningful to the business, then Triple H said that even Vince McMahon is open to anything, saying, quote, "You know, in what you've seen in the past, Progress, ICW, Evolve, all those things, yeah, we're open for business in a lot of ways, in a lot of things, in a lot of everything. People's thoughts, misperceptions, their perceived knowledge of what we do, how we think, and all that stuff is often greatly misinterpreted and not necessarily accurate. So, okay, are we open to the right business opportunities? Yeah, at any given time, we're open to things, and it just depends on what they are and if they're beneficial to us long term. And again, when I say long term, I'm not talking about 3 months or 6 months. Long term, 10 years, you know, 10 years, 15 years from now. Is that beneficial? Is that meaningful? Is that long term? That's how we think. It's much longer in duration, not necessarily worried about the minute by minute. It's the long duration, and so open for business, I think you hear Vince McMahon say that a lot. I've been around him a lot to know that if it's the right thing and it's meaningful to business, he's open to anything, end quote. Would WWE also be up to work with big name promotions somewhere down the line? Triple H sounds optimistic. Mike Chioda questioned Vince McMahon's loyalty after being released of WWE. This past year has been a tough one for many in the pro wrestling industry, and WWE in particular, numerous superstars and backstage personnel were released by the company. Wrestlers, producers, writers, and even referees released by Vince McMahon's company in 2020. One key person who had been in the company for over 30 years and was a senior most referee on the WWE roster, Mike Chioda, was also surprisingly let go by WWE. Chioda's release came out of the blue as he was an important part of the company for 30 plus years. On his new Monday Mailbag podcast, Chioda spoke about how disappointed, heartbroken, and frustrated he was after being released by WWE. He stated that Vince McMahon and the rest of the McMahon family had shown him great loyalty, but he'd wondered where it went at the end, saying, quote, "I can't say Vince didn't reciprocate loyalty. Vince, Linda, Shane, and Stephanie gave me loyalty for 35 years. I don't know where the loyalty went at this point, but it's very disappointing. They couldn't find a spot somewhere to let me retire after all these years in the best company, the only company I've ever been with within 35 years. For 35 years, I've always thought this company did the right way in the professional wrestling business around the world. To be honest with you, it breaks my heart a little bit. I'm annoyed and frustrated why I couldn't finish off my career." End quote. Chioda debuted with Vince McMahon's WWE as a referee back in 1989 and steadily grew up the ranks to become the company's most important referee. The former WWE referee has made appearances for WWE's rivaled AEW in recent times. Vince McMahon's role behind Drew McIntyre's new entrance revealed. Drew McIntyre is one of the top guys in WWE right now and will be defending his championship against AJ Styles at the TLC pay-per-view later this month. According to a recent report from PW Insider, Vince McMahon is hands-on with Drew McIntyre's new entrance with the sword. The report says that Vince McMahon wants everything timed along with the pyro, and he has spent time explaining exactly how he wants Drew McIntyre to handle the sword during his entrance so everything happens just the way he wants it. In a recent interview with Ryan Satin, Drew McIntyre revealed that the sword he uses in his entrance is owned by Vince McMahon himself. In storyline, the sword was presented to McIntyre by Sheamus. McIntyre said Vince had received the sword as a gift from Triple H and Stephanie McMahon. McIntyre added that the idea of him having a sword in his entrance was actually Vince McMahon's, and the WWE CEO himself offered to let McIntyre use his sword, saying, quote, "Until recently we had a conversation about it, and once the boss has something in his head, like as I was just thinking about walking with it, kilt, obviously he likes to take it a little bit further, and suddenly we had the sword. Then we had the pyro, and it was very hands-on with this. And I guess I'll let the cat out of the bag. The sword that I had is actually Vince's sword. It was gifted to him by Stephanie and Hunter that I did not know. I believe the conversation went, we need a sword, we don't have a sword. Sir, I have a sword. And I heard the story and told him, of course you have a sword." Thanks for watching today's SK Wrestling News Roundup. Follow us on all social media. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. Download the Sports Keita app for the most up-to-date stories in the world of wrestling.